Okay, I have to demonstrate my cool new operating system. Since 2009, I've been using Ubuntu, or an Ubuntu derivative, and I have since discovered MX Linux, and it is pretty awesome, so I'm going to share it with you. I got back my awesome Compiz, okay? The visual effects, here, I'll show you. You're seeing some of them right now. So, here, I close that, boom, fire. See, that's pretty cool. Really cool stuff. So that visual bling, as I call it, is a product of the Compiz, and I love it. But in the past, it hasn't worked with the XFCE GUI, which is what I prefer. That's my favorite GUI, or GUI, whatever you want to say, because it's more efficient. It's better for games, you know, whatnot. So that's been my choice. And in the past, it hasn't played well with Compiz. It didn't work on Mint when I used Mint. It certainly didn't work on Xubuntu. Xubuntu was great for a while, for a long while, but it kept getting more and more regressions. Things weren't being fixed. So I finally made the switch. And that's been, it's been traumatic. I can't even tell you. Any rate. Alright, so what do we have? So MX Linux comes with these tools right out of the box. And it just makes things really easy. Installing the video driver was a cinch. Really, really easy. Whoops. Oh, I don't want to do that. Never mind. Oh, and the terminal. Look how awesome this is, man. Look at that. Look at the wobbly windows. Do you have wobbly windows? If you don't have wobbly windows, then you do not have a cool Linux. This is awesome. The package installer, very refined. Notice stable repo or test or backport. That's pretty cool. This is your software center. This is where you add all your stuffs. For instance, this right here added by default, Conky. This is called Conky. You can do all kinds of different clocks, features. You know, you can show parts of the operating system. You know, see what's going on behind the scenes. It's really awesome. Now the reason why I like XFCE, all right, is very important. I love my panel apps. These are my panel apps. Look at this dictionary. Bam! Bam! See? Love it. Dropbox right there. Bam! Media player right there. This Discord right there. See, I have it all right here. I can just boom. I'm pressuring my friend to get this game, Wildlands, which I have to play in fucking Windows. Anyway. So this is really refined. It tells you how, you know, what kind of upgrades you have, how many packages can be upgraded. You can hide the developer stuff. I'm trying to think. I don't know what program we need right now. GIMP. I already have it. It's already installed. See, it's already installed. Maybe I could add this plugin. Boom. Install. It goes to the CLI. I say yes. And then it installs. Boom. It's so easy. So easy. And it doesn't restrict like Mint does. It doesn't say, hey, you can't add this because we don't like this for an upgrade. We don't think it works with our system. And another thing, MX Linux has brought together a lot of software packages, many more than Ubuntu. And so without adding a PPA, it's already there. You don't have to add a bunch of things, you know, later like you do in Ubuntu. So it's good. It's really good. Everything's here. I haven't had to add a PPA yet. So I'm very happy about that. Everything is right here. So far so good. Man, I'm not sure what all to show you. Well, it's, I mean, it's just a really great operating system. Codecs can all be installed. I think that's on here. I think they make it really simple. Look at that. Yeah, you don't have to fuss with anything. They will make sure that you will have all the things you need to play all the media. Boom. Perfect. I don't have to fuss with anything. Unlike Windows, or unlike some other Linux operating system. Everything is right here. And it's running very well. So, I highly recommend this Linux flavor, this Linux distro. I think probably this might be one of the best. I've tried a few. I've had a whole lot of problems. Some were very promising. I'm forgetting which one. I did try a really popular distro recently, and it was very slow. Didn't like that. A lot of people use that slow. This one is fast. This one's fast like Xubuntu, but without all the regressions, without all the bugs, much better. So I highly recommend putting this on a boot drive, you know, flash drive, make it bootable. Use Yumi, Y-U-M-I, use that to create the disk, or the bootable flash drive, and then just take it for a test drive. Boot your computer with it, try it out. It makes it really, really easy. See if everything works, and then install it. It's awesome. And the installer also very easy to use. So highly recommend it. Give it a try. MX Linux. Here's the webpage. This is the webpage. They also have a great team on the forums. I've already interacted with somebody. Super nice. You can get all your help here. They will answer you immediately. So this is a great team. Lots of support. And if this support doesn't work, it's Debian based, so you can just find Debian support, which is everywhere. Even some Ubuntu support might work also with whatever problem you might be having. So give it a try. MX Linux. Peace.